India, as it is known today, is witness to the astounding adventure of gigantic personalities who took upon them the mammoth task of mapping the entire subcontinent. Rightly hailed as the most stupendous works in the history of science, the Great Arc, or more popularly known as the Great Indian Arc of the Meridian, is the amazing saga of human endeavor. A scientific undertaking of Herculean proportions, the Great Indian Arc of the Meridian began in the first half of the 19th century, from Cape Comorin in the south to the foothills of the Himalayas. Taking thousands of lives and costing millions of pounds over five decades, this was at that time the biggest scientific project ever undertaken. The surveyors used hills or temples or even specially built towers as observation points. They cleared jungles and leveled hilltops and villages, only to create a line of sight. They did not give up in times of deadly diseases, attacks by tigers and elephants, and of course, their human enemies. And yet, the results were commensurate. The Great Arc did not only involve the mapping of the Indian subcontinent, but it made it possible to establish the accurate measurement of the Himalayas. More important still, by producing new values of the curvature of the Earth's surface, the Arc helped in significantly advancing the knowledge of the exact shape of the Earth. But how were these measurements done 200 years ago? How did these men, from an era before GPSs, satellites and barometers, map an entire country along with the height of the world's highest mountain? Join us as we resurrect the entire epic tale for you tonight. Mysore. The British and Nizam have joined hands to take over the kingdom of Mysore from under the swords of Tipu Sultan. Today, River Kaveri is at its lowest level. The assault is to begin at 1 p.m. The kingdom of Mysore awaits its destiny. Wellesley wanted maps, but Lambton, who was obsessed with calculating the exact size and shape of the Earth, saw this as a golden opportunity. Lambton's proposal was a meridional arc in India. An arc which would be the longest, the most accurate, and the first in the tropical latitudes. Who knew that the obsession of one man would incite one of the world's greatest discoveries, the Great Arc. About the size of a small tractor and weighing half a ton, theodolites measured angles between different bearings. But only two or three of these boasted of precision and were accurate. One such theodolite was specially commissioned from the Carey of England by William Lambton. But as destiny would have it, the ship carrying Lambton's dream was captured by the French before it could ever reach the Indian soil. 57 days passed by. 400 men and women toiled relentlessly in the southern sun. a 100-foot-long chain was used for measurement. And 400 such measurements had to be done separately. This was how the first baseline at Marina Beach came into being. The French respected science. In fact, geodesy was a national passion. When they realized the cargo of the captured ship contained instrumentation and not artillery, they repacked the theodolite and released the ship with a congratulatory letter to the government of Madras, which reached Lambton. The great chase had begun. Lambton spent the next 6 weeks repairing the instrument inch by inch in his tent. He was aware that this may lead to errors in measurement. But fate seemed to side with Lambton for once. The differences were but negligible. And this is how Lambton measured the longest geodetic arc closest to the equator, from Cape Comorin to the 18th parallel. Two decades have passed, and half of India is still waiting to be mapped. When Lambton went to sleep that night, he never woke up again. The responsibility of taking the great trigonometrical survey of India to its conclusion in Agra descended unexpectedly upon George Everest. It was 400 miles before the greatest arc could be mapped. These 400 miles went across the plains of Ganges. The land was mostly flat. Thus, in the absence of hills, Everest built masonry towers over 60 feet high. The towers once built could not be moved. Some of them are seen even today in various parts of India. By 1833, Everest moved his headquarters to Dehradun, where today the Survey of India building stands proud. Indians were known for their tradition in mathematics and engineering. This led to the appointment of Radhanath Sikdar as the chief computer. Among the snow-capped peaks of Himalayas, Peak 15 particularly interested Sikdar. After four long and arduous years of unscrambling mathematical data, he became the first person to identify it as the world's highest peak. The Mount Everest. On 27th June 2004, an Indian postage stamp was issued commemorating the great trigonometrical survey featuring Nayan Singh and Radhanath Sikdar. This is the boundary where stands the story of such people who, with their undying spirit, created history. In a country with plurality of social, linguistic, religious, and regional identities, a single measurement and a standard map gave a definition to the notion of India, the India of this day.